guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to be doing a recipe from a new cookbook that is coming out for Walt Disney World's 50th anniversary. It's called Cooking Up the Magic, and they released a recipe. Disney Parks blog released a recipe a couple weeks ago for the Empress Lily au gratin potatoes. So because I am having meatloaf tonight, I thought that would go great with it. So that is what we're gonna be making. Now, this recipe is gonna be two large baking potatoes, one cup, a half and half, a half a teaspoon of coarse salt, a fourth teaspoon of pepper, a half a teaspoon of celery salt, and one tablespoon of finely grated onion, which is optional, and three tablespoons of grated cheddar cheese. I don't have large baking potatoes, so what I did was I took four medium-sized ones and I baked them. So as you're gonna see, I'm gonna insert the video here. I cleaned the potatoes and I put them in the oven earlier today so I can have them done and ready to go. And then I will show you the grating process and how it's made. So we'll be right back. I'm gonna go ahead and swing this around. Okay, I was just reading a little bit more about the cookbook, but this is kind of interesting. The Empress Lily is the name of a river boat that was on the shore of Disney Springs. It's now, home to the Paddlefish restaurant. The boat was named for Lillian, Walt's wife, and this is an original recipe that was at that dining location, and that was 1977. Wow. Okay, so I'm not gonna say anything, but 1977 sounds old, but in reality, I was, what, 11. Okay, so I just thought I'd mention that. I'm gonna go ahead and swing it around and we can show you how this recipe is gonna go. Okay, so now, all the potatoes were cooked. It does say two large baking potatoes. I didn't have large ones, so I made four medium-sized ones, and I think that should be fine. And I went ahead and peeled off the skins, like it says. And now what we're gonna do is grate them. It says refrigerate to cool, then peel and coarsely grate. So that's what I'm gonna do now. And we'll speed this up so you can see. So what's happening is, as I'm grating them, the potatoes are actually like coming into pieces. So it's getting to be a little hard to grate them without them falling apart. But we'll do the best we can and we'll see what happens. Yeah. Let's speed this up. So the potatoes are all peeled and grated. There are some larger chunks in there, and it's just gonna have to be like that because it was too hard to grate them down to the end. And now what we're gonna do is we're gonna go ahead and bring half and half, let's see how much, a cup of half and half to a boil in a small saucepan over medium heat. Then we're gonna add the salt, pepper, celery salt, and onion. And what did I need? Oh, I needed to do grate the onion, optional. I'm gonna do it. and then we're gonna mix in the potatoes. And then we will take it from there. Okay, let me go get that onion and the rest of the ingredients and I will show you what it looks like. Okay, so the half and half is boiling, and now what we're gonna do is go ahead and add the salt, pepper, and what else? And the celery salt, okay. So let me put pepper in. And what did I do with the salt? Oh! Salt. And the celery salt and the onion. I'm stepping in front here. Okay, so now what? Then we're gonna mix in the grated potatoes. Okay, let me go ahead and move this closer. So let me just move that. Okay, mix in the potatoes. Smells really good, I have to say. And the oven is preheated, 350. Okay. So now, okay. So now we're gonna spoon potato. That's Michael. Okay. So now we're gonna spoon the mixture. The potatoes into a buttered pan. I'm just going to use this. I don't have a lot. I think it's, you know, I think it's okay for what we're going to be making here. And I don't know what I did with the spoon. I just had it. Okay. Use this one. Let me bring you closer. Okay. So just saying, spoon potatoes into a buttered 1-quart baking dish and sprinkle with the cheese, which I still have to measure out. Things. I don't know what they are, but they're adorable. Okay. So I did it like that. God, it smells really good. All right, let me go get the cheese. Okay, so it calls for 3 tablespoons of shredded cheddar cheese. And I'm just going to put enough kind of cover it, right? Yeah, I'm gonna, because first of all, it's a little hard to get it out of this. And it doesn't look like it's even. There's nothing wrong with a little more cheese. Okay. A little bare spot here. Okay. So now this is what it looks like. And we're gonna put it in the oven, 350, and it's 15 to 20 minutes. So I'm gonna go ahead and pop that in and then I'll show you what it looks like when it's done. Okay, all done. Smells good, looks good, all bubbly, brown on top. I think it's gonna taste delicious. I will let you know, maybe I can cut a little piece into it just so you could see. Let me lay this down on here. And let me get okay, let's see. Let me get this pot holder. Let me just take a little bit. Ooh, it is smoking. Looks good. Not bad. And actually this is a perfect serving size for us. I don't know. I doubt that Alex is gonna like this, but I'm pretty sure Michael will, and I know my husband will. Anything to do with potatoes, he is all about that. Anyway, that's it, guys. Give me another look. I just put it back in there. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please give it a thumbs up. Don't forget to comment, share, subscribe. Hit the bell so you know when I post my next Disney recipe. And I'll see you next time. Have a great day.